Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. And this is lecture number 9.1, 9th chapter, first lecture. We are going to discuss about the topic flow through pipes. So in this lecture, we will be discussing about the Reynolds experiment, flow through pipes, major losses and minor losses. We recap from the earlier lecture. So in the previous lecture, we discussed about the laminar flow or the viscous flow and turbulent flow and the boundary layer theory. The learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define Reynolds number and its significance, calculate the major and minor losses in flow through the pipe. And the Reynolds experiment is conducted with this apparatus. So this is the schematic of the Reynolds experiment, apparatus for the Reynolds experiment. We have a tank with water and a glass tube. At the end of the glass tube, we have a valve. So at the center of the pipeline, we have the nozzle or the tip of the dye injector. So here again we have the valve to regulate the flow of the dye, and the dye is flowing through the leaving injected through the small nozzle here. And we maintain constant level of water, constant head is maintained in the tank and the water is continuously flowing. Then we are setting to a particular flow rate. So the flow rate, the valve is regulated, so we can gradually open the valve so that we can allow more flow of water. So initially we are setting the valve for a particular flow rate, and the dye quantity is regulated here. So we set the dye quantity, and the fluid, the dye is flowing along with the water. For initially, Reynolds observed that the jet, the dye particle, they are moving in a straight line. So that that is plotted here. Along the length of the pipe, the dye is flowing in a straight line. So the flow, now the flow is concluded as laminar flow. So in the laminar flow, the fluid particle moving in a straight line without crossing the streamline. So it is streamlined flow of the fluid particle. So everywhere in the pipeline, so the fluid is flowing in a streamlined fashion, the flow is laminar. Then the flow is adjusted, so the flow is increased. So when we increase the flow, after some change in the flow rate, the fluctuation in the flow occurs. The fluctuation, the dye is flowing and it is fluctuating. So the injection of the dye, the flow of the dye is recorded here, and you may find some fluctuation for a small portion of the entire length of the pipe, and this is called as transitional flow. So the from laminar to turbulent, so it is called as transitional flow. And when you further regulate the flow in the glass tube, the fluctuation is vigorous. So the dye is flowing in this fashion in the pipeline. So this is called as turbulent flow. So by regulating the flow for a particular type of fluid, he observed laminar flow, transitional flow and turbulent flow. Reynolds conducted this experiment for different types of liquid and different types of jet, different length of the pipe, different diameter of the pipe and different flow rate. So by varying different parameter, length of the pipe, diameter of the pipe and then density of the fluid, viscosity of the fluid. By changing the fluid, density and viscosity will change, fluid properties will change. So by conducting different experiments, he concluded that the following observations were made by the Reynolds. When the velocity of the flow was low, the dye filament in the glass tube was in the form of straight line and parallel to the glass tube. So this is known as laminar flow. With the increase in velocity of the flow, the dye filament become wavy and flow is no longer laminar. When the velocity of the flow was further increased, the wavy dye filament was diffused in the glass tube. This is due to the intermingling of the fluid particle, and the flow is known as turbulent flow. The velocity at which the transition from laminar flow to turbulent flow occurs is called as critical velocity. So, Reynolds discovered that the transition from laminar to turbulent was governed by the relative magnitude of inertia and the viscous forces. So, the Reynolds related the inertia and viscous forces and defined a non-dimensional number called Reynolds number, which is given as Re equal to Reynolds number equal to inertia force by viscous force, where inertia force is the mass into acceleration. So, mass equal to density into volume and acceleration. So, we calculate density rho, volume L cube into L by T square is the acceleration. So, L cube is the length to the power 3, L by T square is the meter per second square. So, rho L square by T square equal to rho L square by V square. So, L square by T square equal to velocity. So, change in length with respect to time is the velocity. So, rho L square V square. And the viscous force equal to shear stress into area. So, shear stress is given by Newton's law of viscosity, mu into du by dy into L square. Area is the L square. Now, mu into du by dy equal to V by L. Change in velocity with respect to distance. Here in this experiment, it is V by L into L square. And this becomes mu V L. So, substituting for inertia force and the viscous force, Reynolds number equal to rho L square V square by rho mu into V into L, which is rho V L divided by mu, where rho is the density of the fluid, mu is the dynamic viscosity of the fluid, V is the characteristic velocity, and the L is the characteristic linear dimension. So, when the Reynolds number, so in the case of flow through the pipeline, the characteristic linear dimension is taken as diameter of the pipeline. So, Reynolds number equal to rho V D by mu, which is V D by nu. So, nu is the kinematic viscosity of the fluid, which is mu by rho, dynamic viscosity divided by the density of the fluid. The limiting values of Reynolds number for the flow through pipeline is given below. So, for different values of Reynolds number, so up to 2000, Reynolds number 2000, the flow is laminar. When the Reynolds number is 2000 to 4000, the transition from laminar to turbulent occurs. When the Reynolds number is above 4000, the flow becomes turbulent flow for the flow through the pipeline for any value of velocity, diameter and kinematic viscosity. So, what is the significance of this non-dimensional number? Suppose if you want to determine the velocity with which the velocity at which the flow is laminar, we have to calculate V separately, D separately, the effect of nu separately. Now, these three are combined together and it is formed as a non-dimensional number called Reynolds number. So, Reynolds number, it may vary with respect to velocity, diameter and the nu. It will increase with the velocity, increase with the diameter and decrease with the increase in kinematic viscosity. So, Reynolds number, it is grouping four variables, rho, V, D by mu. So, when you change any one of the parameter, Reynolds number will change. So, combining all the four parameters. So, here look at here. Rho and mu, they are called as fluid property. V is called as flow property. Velocity is the flow property. And D is the geometrical property. So, three properties. Flow property, fluid property and geometrical property. In any non-dimensional number, all the three will be there or minimum two will be there. So, geometrical property, fluid property and flow property. So, the non-dimensional number, it is simplifying our analysis, it is simplifying our experiment, number of experiment for determining the flow is whether laminar flow or turbulent flow. So, the Reynolds number, it is used to distinguish, particularly Reynolds number is used to distinguish whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. When the value is less than 2000, the flow is laminar. When the value is greater than 4000, the flow is turbulent. And when this is between 2000 and 4000, the flow is transition from laminar to turbulent. And next we calculate the losses, energy losses in the pipeline. So, there are two types of losses, major losses and minor losses. First we calculate the major losses, then we calculate the minor losses. The major losses are due to the friction and it is calculated by Darcy-Weisbach formula or Chessy formula. The loss of energy due to this head is much more than the other modes of energy losses. In the pipeline, the losses of head is major losses and minor losses. major losses, there will be more major loss and minimum minor losses. And the minor losses sometimes we neglect. So the major loss, the frictional losses is very important. Frictional losses is the major losses in the flow through the pipeline. And the frictional losses in the pipeline, they are calculated by two equations. Darcy-Weisbach, which is very popular. Chessie formula is also another formula to calculate the frictional losses. So Darcy-Weisbach formula, so this formula already we have developed. We have discussed in the earlier discussion, laminar flow as well as in the turbulent flow. HF equal to 4 FL V square by 2 GD. F is the friction coefficient, L is the length of the pipe, V is the velocity, D is the diameter of the pipe, and the value of the F value depending on the Reynolds number. That means depending on the laminar flow or turbulent flow, type of the flow. When the Reynolds number is less than 2000, that is the flow is laminar, friction factor F equal to 16 by Reynolds number. When the flow is turbulent, the F equal to 0.079 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.25. So, this is very important equation which is popularly used to calculate the frictional losses in the pipeline. So, this you have to remember. HF equal to 4 FL V square by 2 GD is very, very popular equation, and F value will be given in the problem. If it is not given, we have to calculate using the equation depending on the flow condition. And the Chessie formula to determine the loss of head due to friction is given by V equal to C into square root of M into I, where V is the mean velocity of the flow, C is the Chessie's constant, which is C equal to square root of rho g by F dash, and I is the loss of head per unit length in the pipe given by I equal to HF by L, and then M is the hydraulic mean depth of hydraulic radius is given by M equal to D by 4, and where D is the diameter of the pipeline. So, using this, we can calculate the I value. Using this equation, we calculate the I value, then we calculate the HF value, which is the head loss due to friction. And in the problem, if it is mentioned that you calculate by Chessie formula, then only you refer the Chessie formula, calculate the head loss due to friction. Otherwise, the Darcy-Weisbach equation is very popular in calculating the frictional losses in the pipeline. And the minor losses are due to the change in velocity in the flow direction. There are different reasons for the minor losses. Loss of head due to sudden enlargement, loss of head due to the sudden contraction, loss of head due to the entrance of the pipe, loss of head due to the exit of the pipe, loss of head due to the obstruction in the pipeline, loss of head due to the bend in the pipe, and loss of head due to the various pipe fittings. So, we calculate one by one. There are equations available to calculate every minor losses. We calculate one by one. First, the loss of head due to the sudden enlargement. So, look at this kind of situation. So, this will be available in the large pipe network for water supply in the municipality or even at our home. We connect the overhead tank with different bath fitting in our home. So, everywhere we may find some fittings, we may find some bend, we may find some enlargement or contraction. So, in all the contraction enlargement, we have to calculate the frictional losses. Then only we can calculate the overall pumping power required for the pumping the water. So, here due to the sudden enlargement, we look at the diagram. So, from the pipeline, so the small diameter pipeline of area A1, suddenly it is enlarged. So, here section 2-2 and 1-1, section 1-1, we have the pressure P1, velocity V1 and area A1, and section 2-2, we have pressure P2, velocity V2 and area A2. Now, applying the Bernoulli's equation between section 1-1 and 2-2, so P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2 plus HE. So, HE is the head loss due to the enlargement. So, for HE is the loss of head due to the enlargement, and for horizontal pipe, Z1 equal to Z2, so HE equal to P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g plus V1 square by 2G minus V2 square by 2G, which is given as HE equal to V1 minus V2 whole square by 2G. And loss of head due to the contraction. So, this is the pipeline. So, the reverse of the previous diagram. So, we have a large pipeline. Suddenly, the flow is changed to a smaller pipeline. So, now the flow is adjusting. There are some losses here. You can find here. There will be some circulation. And the flow is suddenly decreasing the diameter of the flow, and the cross section of the flow is decreasing, and then it is developing. and the area with the smaller cross section for the flow is called as vena contracta. So above the vena contracta you may find some circulation, so that these are all the losses due to the sudden contraction in the flow path. And the head loss due to the sudden contraction is given by hc equal to k into v2 square by 2g, where k is the constant, which is 1 by cc minus 1 whole square, where cc is the ac by a2. So ac is the area of the section cc vena contracta, and a2 is the area of the section 22. If the value, if the cc value is not given, we can take k equal to 0.5. So hc becomes 0.5 v2 square by 2g. Normally we will be referring, we will be using 0.5 v2 square by 2g for sudden contraction. And loss of heat due to the entrance of the pipe. So when the fluid is, pipe is entering to a tank, hi equal to 0.5 v2 square by 2g. The loss of heat when the exit of the pipe. So we have a tank, one pipe is admitting water into the pipeline, into the tank, and another pipe is taking the water to the delivery to the other side. So HO at the exit side, HO equal to V2 square by 2G, where V is the velocity of the outlet pipe. Loss of heat due to the bend in the pipe, HB equal to KV square by 2G. Then where K is the coefficient of bend, depends on the angle of the bend, radius of curvature and diameter of the pipeline. The value K will be given in the problem. And loss of heat due to the various fittings, pipe fittings, this is equal to KV square by 2G, where K is the coefficient of pipe fitting. So the K value will be given in the problem. And the loss of weight due to the obstruction in the flow. So the loss of weight is, but due to the obstruction, some obstruction is there available in the pipeline. So because of the obstruction, the flow loss, there will be loss of head. So when there is obstruction in the flow path, the loss occurs due to the reduction in the flow area for the of the pipe. Where let A is the maximum area of the obstruction, capital A is the area of the pipe, V is the velocity of the fluid. The head loss due to the obstruction equal to V square by 2G into A by CC minus capital A minus small a minus 1 whole square. Where CC is the coefficient of contraction, so which is area of the vena contracta divided by capital A minus small a, which is AC by capital A minus small a. Then, so we stop here. So these are all the various losses. So the next lecture we will combine all the losses to calculate the overall loss of head in the compound pipe or pipe in parallel, and we will solve problems so that you can understand the impact of the minor losses and the major losses in the overall total loss of the total loss of head in the pipe flow. So we stop here. These are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subjects, and you may find fluid mechanics and machinery which is useful for this particular subject. You can refer to it. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject mentioned here. Also, the solution for gate question paper are also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel and use the video lectures for your better learning and passing the gate examination. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments and subscribe the channel. You can contact me through my WhatsApp number or the email ID for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again in another video lecture in the subject fluid mechanics.